F1 2019 is the official game of the 2019 Formula 1 and Formula 2 championships. It is brought to us by Codemasters. This is the 12th title in the series done by this studio, and it was released on Xbox in August of 2019. I played this on an Xbox One X, a 27-inch 4K HDR monitor, and using Turtle Beach Stealth 600 headphones. I did play using the standard controller that comes with the Xbox. This is a racing career simulation game. It focuses on racing the cars. It has segments of talking to the press. You have to direct your team's R&D departments. You are basically doing everything for a full career in racing. It is not only racing, it is for the whole career. The art style in this game is realistic. The visual experience in this game is amazing in 4K. I could watch someone play this game. It's almost as good as watching the real thing as far as the realism that you see and how good the graphics look. The audio for this game puts you right in the action. The menu music is a little bit laid back, but once you start a race, the music sounds like it's coming right off of a major sports station. When you're in the car before the race, it sounds like you're down at the track. You've got kind of track noises going on around you. It really kind of puts you in the action. And then, of course, once you're out there driving, you are hearing the car, you are hearing the track itself. And if you have good enough bass, you'd probably feel the rumble as you went across the strips too. This game normally costs $50. Right now, with Game Pass, you can get it for $40. There is a Legend Edition that is normally $60, which you can get for $48 as of the time of this recording. That comes with both DLC packs for the game. There are over 100 items listed in the Microsoft Store as add-ons for this game. Most of these consist of driver outfits, helmet designs, and car skins, ranging in price from 50 cents to $6 or $7. Speaking of Game Pass, this month's quest was to complete 15 laps. This was easily done in the game during the F2 season, which is kind of the opener to the game. This was not an achievement-safe quest, though. I did get a couple of achievements on my way to completing the quest. While this game might not be achievement safe, this video is safe to like. If you want to hear about these Game Pass games and the quests associated with them as they come out, make sure you like this, and YouTube will surface more of these videos for you to watch, and I'll know to keep making them. In this game, you are the story. You are racing in Formula One, you are trying to build your career, you get to shape your career, you choose who you race with within the parameters of who will accept you based on your choices. You improve yourself. You have goals to reach based on your career path. The entire game revolves around you as the story in career mode. There are, of course, non-career mode racing that you can do. These don't have a story, it's just racing at that point. The racing mechanics in this game are easily picked up as far as gas, brake, steering. And there are difficulty settings, which I had set to make it as easy as possible for myself. But you can actually turn this into quite the racing simulation where you are in control of a lot of this car. The career simulator and actual racing both go very, very deep if you wanted to. There's a lot more there than I was able to investigate, and quite honestly for me, career mode is not really my favorite, so I didn't try to investigate that very far. The gameplay loop in this is twofold. You have races and you have a career. There's a lot of replayability here, whether you just want to get better at racing and better at races, or whether you want to have the ultimate F1 racing career. You'll find your game here somewhere. There are some things I did not like about this game. There was a lack of direction in the career simulator. Once you got through kind of the opening F2 season, you got your team that you were going to be part of, you really kind of got sat down and left alone to figure it out on your own. There is a training menu where you can learn about how to drive the F1 car, kind of learn how to play the game, but it was hidden, it wasn't easy to find. This game has a lot of DLC. I remember the days before paid for DLC, so I'm a little biased here in saying that there's too much DLC. A lot of people enjoy customization, and most people will maybe spend a couple bucks on the customizations they like and call it good. The interview segments part of this game just really didn't do it for me. I can see how they tie into the greater career mode, but they felt out of place, they felt forced, almost contrived. They could have worked on these a little bit better, made them a little bit nicer, and it might have fit better, but for me, they just didn't work. And finally, there's a rewind race function that I felt didn't fit with the career mode aspirations of the game. On the other hand, there are some things I like about this game as well, and we'll start off with that rewind race function. when you're playing this game as a racer, it's awesome to be able to just kind of rewind a little bit and catch that corner that you didn't catch, but you know you usually can. So, as much as I didn't like that in the career mode, I do like it in the racing mode. The visuals in this game were, of course, amazing. The game translates to 4K wonderfully, and I actually look forward to playing this one on the Xbox Series X, because I think it's going to get some improvements. The sound stage was great. You really felt like you were right there in the car. If you've got good headphones, you're going to really enjoy playing this game for the visuals and the sound. I liked the driving in this game. It was a lot of fun to drive around the tracks, to race, to try to beat other people, to try to get the best line, try to get your acceleration and braking, and try to just ride that corner as fast as you can while maintaining a solid line through it. And I like that there is a career mode. This mode wasn't really for me, but it's there for other people, and it's a very good career mode. It's a very deep career mode. From the little interaction I've had with it, people that are into this type of thing are going to love this game. My final verdict on this game, if you want a racing career sim, you should buy this. The price for this game, which is almost two games in one between the career mode and the racing, feels high, but this is a AAA title. This game is appropriately priced for what you're going to get here. On that same token, if you just want a race sim, I wouldn't purchase this game. You'd be better off finding a pure racing sim for this price, or finding something else that's a little bit cheaper. For me personally, I'm going to pass on this game because I don't want a career sim, I just want a racing sim. If you like this review format, make sure you subscribe down below so that you hear about more of these as they come out. I try to do these reviews for all of the Game Pass games that get quests on them, and the more people subscribe, the better chance I'll have of getting them all done on time.